62 tonight, mainly clear. Tomorrow looks like a pretty nice one. Matter of fact, it will be one of our cooler days as highs only climb to the upper 80s. There's a good reason for it. We'll get to in detail about that in just a bit. Meanwhile, we've been right up against that 100 degree mark this afternoon in Roswell. Carlsbad, we're at 100. 95 in Hobbs. We have 80s off to our north from Los Alamos back towards Taos. Triple digit heat up around Tucumcari. Dew point slowly on the, at least decreasing. Of course, yesterday we were very juicy. What's going on is we've got this dry northwesterly flow moving into the region. Wind speed's a little breezy this afternoon in parts of the state, so that is to be expected, especially along our central mountain chain. But tomorrow could get a little gustier for folks out towards the west, especially as another front dives on in. So that's going to be the story tomorrow. Thursday's front is going to cool temperatures off, especially across most of the east. Meanwhile, not much of a cool-off for the west. We could see a few spotty mountain showers. The weekend, that ridge moves overhead, bringing that monsoon to places around Arizona and right along the west reaches of New Mexico. And then perhaps by latter part of the weekend and into next week, we could see some of that moisture sneaking into the state. A little bit more abundant moisture, that is. As far as what we're going to see overnight tonight and into tomorrow, not a whole lot. Friday, we could see a few showers popping up to our south as we continue to shunt the moisture down south of here, courtesy of that high, but still we could see a little bit sneak up into the southern reaches of the state. Latest on Hurricane Bill, it is a Category 4 with sustained winds at 135 miles per hour. The track of this is taking it through the Bahamas and then curling up right outside the east coast, as you can see here, moving up towards the north. So I don't think we're going to see any direct impact, thank goodness, but the current track, 5-day track, taking it in that general direction. Temperatures right now in the 70s back off to our north and east. We have 80s up around Denver, 60s and 70s across the west coast, and it looks like tonight we'll drop in the 50s to our north, 70s to our south, of course, to the southeast as well. Tomorrow's highs anywhere from the 70s to the west coast, hundreds from Boise down to El Paso and San Antonio. Meanwhile, the upper Midwest will be in the cool area, 60s and 70s to Rapid City down up towards International Falls. Now it looks like highs tomorrow, again, not looking too bad. We'll actually see cooler temperatures into the 80s, so those are actually the highs for today. But overnight lows will be in the 40s, 50s, and 60s tonight, so we will get that much-needed cool-off. There's the 7-day forecast. It's not going to be nearly as hot, thank goodness. 89 degrees for the high. 94 on Friday. Will slowly creep up near 100 degrees by the weekend with partly to mostly sunny skies. And shower chances will be on the increase, of course, next week as we tap into that moisture from the south. Highs will be in the low to mid 90s in the meantime, and overnight lows hanging on to the low to mid 60s to upper 60s as well. So we're going to have a good stretch of dry weather before we see that monsoon creeping back into the forecast next week.